In February of 2001, while interviewing potential subjects for a documentary about the changing nature of relationships in the new millennium, we were introduced to a young man convinced he and his partner had come up with a new and better way of loving. That spring, they agreed to let us chronicle their new and better way in action. Tell us about your plan.
Well, our plan is pretty simple, actually. It's like most good ideas. It's so obvious, you're shocked no one ever thought of it before.
We're breaking up.
Essentially.
Well, in a better way.
I think we found a better way.
Why is it better?
Nobody gets hurt. Nobody ends up alone.
We don't end up hating each other.
How are you going to manage this?
Well, Melanie and I have been dating for a year and a half, and that's not dating, but I mean living together and loving together, mm-hmm. the whole deal. I think it's been pretty great.
It has been, mm-hmm. yeah.
But we've come to that dreaded 19-month stage, and rather than cling to an expired relationship, we're moving on.
Mm-hmm. Why 19 months?
Oh, because that's how long it lasts.
Mm-hmm. Studies have shown that romantic love lasts about 19 months, and I think our personal experience pretty much backs that up.
Oh, yeah. Mm-hmm.
What do you mean by romantic love?
Oh, you know, passionate love, that I can't stand being away from you kind of love, you know, that I just want to, fuck you all the time,
yeah,
you know,
yeah, you're stop, just, stop. It's the first few months, right? And then I think you can settle into something pretty nice after that. It's where the other person is still enough of a stranger to be erotic, but you don't find yourselves just hanging on for fear of being alone.
So you're just ending it?
No.
No, not exactly. Melanie and I, we still care about one another, and I don't want to see Melanie suffer. I don't think she wants to see me suffer. So, we've decided, right?
Mm-hmm.
We've agreed.
Yeah.
We're going to sort of help each other make the transition. And I think one of the reasons a lot of potentially good breakups go bad is because one of the partners finds someone before the other. So, that one ends up feeling alone and bitter. We're not going to officially break up until we've both found new partners,
mm-hmm.
right?
Yeah, I mean, basically, these things, relationships, for both of us, haven't always ended well.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, you end up wondering how someone who loved you could end up hating you.
Mm-hmm. Taints the whole good part of the experience.
Yeah, exactly.
Right? Mm-hmm. I mean, it seems so unnecessary. I think if you're honest about it, if you're mature about it, if you can sort of stay on the same page as your partner, it should be a relatively smooth transition.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, why can't we be grown up about breaking up?
Yeah, exactly. Mm-hmm.
We got the feeling Rob and Melanie wanted to be alone, so we left early that evening. The next day, they decided to spend one more official night together as a couple.
Melanie? Anything?
Yeah, I got a couple. Do you want to check them out?
Sure. No. No. Fuck no. I might want to see this. But not tonight. And what is this?
That got two thumbs up.
Mm-hmm. Hey, two delighted thumbs up.
What? It might be fun.
All right, bye. Fun, you mean quirky, yeah. Well, we'll be expected to root for some obnoxious lout, drives a moped, lives in a giant loft, and he'll be fucking Irish or Scottish. He'll have some stupid pet like a monkey or a fucking tuna. Love interest will look like Cyndi Lauper, right? Some little scamp in recycled clothes.
Okay, well, what then? What do you want to see?
I don't know, nothing.
Nothing?
I just don't think I'm in the mood.
The horse races.
Yeah.
Doesn't have to be quirky.
What is with this quirky obsession?
You don't have to start doing, you know, weird shit. Just
What are you talking about?
We're on an American game show, okay? You don't have to start doing weird shit. Just act normal, be yourself.
I am being myself. I thought it might be fun. Don't shush me.
Anything you want.
How about mini golf?
Mini golf, are you serious?
Oh, my goodness!
Melanie is anxious about her first show opening in 6 weeks.
How long have you been painting?
How long? All my life.
So what are these all about?
Oh, I don't know. They are what they are, you know? You don't want to overthink it.
Right. They have an unfinished quality to them.
Oh, well, no, they're finished. It's just that they're not complete. I mean, that's kind of the point. It's, well, I mean, who's to say, right? I used to spend so much time trying to figure out what some of these guys were thinking, you know, like other boyfriends. You ask them what's wrong, and they say nothing. Act like you're the one who's crazy. And then just one day, bam, they go nuts on you. No, not Rob. If he's going to be angry about something, he tells me before.
Doesn't sound very spontaneous.
Yeah, I know. But it's nice to be in a relationship where you can kind of feel calm inside. And there's no big secrets looming around corners. I mean, I can focus on my work, right? I mean, I can lose myself here. I can be spontaneous here.
Rob, meanwhile, is studying for his psychology exams.
Yeah, the other kids are all cramming now, trying to learn an entire semester of material in one day. But I never studied the day before an exam. You stayed on top of things, it's not necessary. I'm gonna just have a nice, easy day, get a good sleep, do a brief review when I wake up, go to the exam feeling confident, fresh.
Aren't the other kids all in their 20s?
So?
You've been in school a long time.
Okay, I see what you're getting at. It's because I have 4 degrees in seemingly unrelated subjects. You assume some sort of immaturity on my part, like I can't decide or commit.
I didn't say that.
I have an English degree, a history degree, a fine arts degree. Pretty soon I'll have a psychology degree. Next year I'm thinking about biology, or possibly philosophy. It's like the Greeks. I feel an obligation to truly try to understand all aspects of the world before I go off pretending to be some kind of doctor, lawyer, author. Yeah, I'm surrounded with these 20-year-old kids who claim to know exactly what they want. But who at 20 knows enough about anything to be making decisions about the rest of their lives? And when did becoming a well-informed, well-rounded person become such a frivolous idea?
Don't you think it's frivolous to break up with a woman because her 19 months are up?
I suppose. I suppose if you believe everything you learn from Meg Ryan movies, it is.
Meaning?
Those movies always end when they get together. And that's the best part. So, sure, they're gonna have a good time and some hot sex, get that love high for a while, and that's great. I mean, that's wonderful. Don't get me wrong. But then it changes. It always changes. When you're in the middle of it, you think, maybe this time it won't. But it always does. That's just science. We're not wired for forever. I mean, you can still have feelings for the person and care about the person, but passion fades. One day you look at the person next to you and you think, oh, I wish I could be with someone else. Just I want to talk to someone else, love someone else. I want to fuck someone else, but, well, you're afraid to let it go, and you don't want to risk that comfort and be alone, so, yeah. Which is why I think the way Melanie and I are handling the breakup acts superior, because we're going to kind of bypass a lot of that scary stuff. It's that stuff that keeps billions of people in relationships long after their expiry date.
Rob thought it might be a good idea if they figured out the qualities they were looking for in their prospective new mates.
So let's just, you know, take your time. Let's not go crazy here. You know, this isn't, you're not making a laundry list. My Next Boyfriend by Melanie Chambers. It's cute. First off, he should be funny and extremely honest, like Rob. Thank you. Mm-hmm. This time, however, I think I'd like someone taller and a little more in shape. Lately, I've been very curious about some of the black guys I see at the gym. Wonder what it would be like to have that hard, dark body hovering over me, running my hands down that perfect, sweet, smooth back and clenching that taut ass. He never mentioned this before.
Mm-hmm.
Also nice if he had a car and liked dogs. Well, I like dogs, Melanie. I do. I think they belong outside. They smell bad. They eat garbage. Why not have the local Rummy come live with you?
I don't want to live with the Rummy. I just want a dog.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, they're cute. They give you unconditional love.
Oh, that's not love. That's feed me, sucker. They're parasites. They're con artists, really.
Okay, whatever. I just want someone that doesn't feel that way.
Okay, well, it shouldn't be a problem finding a hillbilly with a pickup truck and a shaggy dog.
Okay, good.
Yeah, world is your oyster.
Look, are we going to do this or what?
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. Yeah, this is good. This is a good start. It's a little sketchy, but a good start.
Well, it's hard to know these things exactly, Rob.
I know. It's going to take some time.
Well, you got?
I was blocked, too.
Really?
No, sorry. I haven't thought this through properly. But...
You've drawn a picture of a woman with a giant ass. Giant ass and no head.
Head is going to go right here.
Melanie and her older sister, Paige, meet for lunch and shop most Saturdays.
What do you think of Rob and Melanie's breakup plan?
Well, I'm all for the breakup part. As for the plan, I think it's kind of stupid. I think they should just do it.
So you don't like Rob?
I didn't say that.
Well, then why do you want them to break up?
Because I don't like Rob.
Why not?
Oh, God, I wouldn't know where to begin. Well, that all-knowing attitude of his can be pretty trying. Well, like, when he's talking to you, he acts like he's really focused, you know? Like he knows you better than you know yourself. And then he comes out with some sort of bullshit he read somewhere, you know? Like some half-understood concept. This breakup plan isn't his first bright idea. He's still in school, you know. And frankly, I don't think he's all that good looking. And as far as I can tell, he doesn't have any friends, so that should tell you something. What else?
Spoke to Paige then, huh? Sort of sad, isn't she? She's angry. Yeah, just keep in mind, she's hated all Melanie's boyfriends. She's been fucked around a few times. Had some kind of weird shit with one of her uncles.
She thinks the plan is stupid.
Mm-hmm. Well, she thinks everything is stupid. She wants the usual ugly breakup so she can be there to pick up the pieces. Oh, God. You know that expression, misery loves company? Well, God knows. She needs the company. Yeah. What she really wants is Melanie to be alone and dependent so she can play out some kind of weirdo, whatever happened to Baby Jane type scenario.
She says you have no friends.
Mm-hmm. Well, that's not true. In fact, I'm seeing my old pal Steve tonight.
Rob? Yeah, I guess you could say he's a friend. I don't see him much when he gets a new girlfriend. He used to piss me off, but... Then he's single again. He wants to hang out all the time. Gets in a real panic to meet women. Starts asking me about my sister. Just borrow my dog. Then he finds somebody pretty quick, and then I don't see him for a while. Grade school. We used to ride together. If somebody calls, says they want to hang out, what are you gonna say?
Sorry, what?
What are you doing tonight?
Oh, I'm just going out with some old friends.
We're cool.
clear on what tonight's about, right?
Yeah, going out separate, getting used to it, seeing what's out there.
Right, but more simply, it's about easing into the next step, getting used to not being 100% in each other's lives.
I know. I can't believe you're wearing that.
What?
That shirt. You look so cute in it.
Oh, come on, I look cute in all my shirts.
You wearing an aftershave? And since when did you blow dry your hair?
You were running late, it was wet.
You know, I see what you're doing. Why don't I just go put my Catholic school kilt on, huh?
No, I honestly don't care what you wear, Melanie.
Okay, I will.
You can go topless if you want.
Maybe I will.
Oh, boy.
We decided to follow Rob and catch up with Melanie later in the evening.
Well, say some guy walks by wearing stupid pants and you say, hey, who's this clown? Suddenly you're being judgmental. I bet the person who winds up stuck talking to this guy at a party wishes he had been a little more judgmental. I bet the person who winds up married to this fucker wishes they had been a little more judgmental.
Yeah, yeah. No, I see what you're saying. Mm-hmm. It's true.
Yeah. What's your sister up to these days?
Not much. Still married.
They don't get a lot of women in here, do they?
Yeah. No. Not a lot.
Steve and Rob weren't up to much, so we decided to try and catch up with Melanie.
Yeah. All right. Childhood buddy or something. Born in 20s. Where's Melanie? Did she leave with somebody? For the documentary crew filming the film about Rob and Melanie?
Why?
What channel do you work for?
We're independent.
Oh, that means
you don't
get paid, right?
What did you do, Mommy?
What? What do you do? Okay, let's go.
That was a joke.
I know.
It's you guys. So, we catch up with Melanie.
She's not here.
No. You want to come in?
Sure.
Well, they must have gone to an after-hours bar. Is that right? Is it really 4 a.m.? Has happened. How many shots of me reading do you need? Do you want to ask me a question? Thought I heard something. Hey, is the phone, did you guys unplug the phone? Well, fuck her.
What are you doing?
What am I doing? You don't have any idea what time it is.
Oh, I don't believe you.
I was just about to call the police. I thought you were lying dead somewhere.
No, you just thought I was lying down somewhere.
Were you?
It's none of your business.
Well, I don't care. I'd like to know.
Oh, you don't care. So why are you staying out here at 6 o'clock in the morning?
Standing out here. I was looking for your corpse in the bushes.
Oh.
So, just like that.
Hmm?
Well, that's incredible. It's incredible. You're out there for maybe an hour. First guy that comes along you think is maybe the one. What about the odds are on that? Let's calculate those odds.
Maybe
we should calculate those odds.
I don't want to calculate now, Rob. I'm too tired. Come on,
tell
yourself about this
morning. Oh, look. It's morning. You know, the whole idea was just to get it. Take a look around, you know, see what's out there. Not go chasing after the first... Thoughtful, informed choice, knowing we still have each other to come home to.
You're okay.
I thought we found a better way. I thought it might even be revolutionary. This documentary going here, and we're ready to show the world a new way of loving and a better way of loving that you have to go off like some kind of dingbat. You really made us look like idiots.
What am I supposed to do?
Soon after, they went to bed. Melanie insisted she just wanted to be held. Rob ended up sleeping on the sofa.
So, what's his name?
His name is Glenn.
You seem reluctant to talk about it.
No, I just don't want to make a big deal about it just yet. You know, you never know how these things are going to go.
How did you meet?
Oh, I was sick of dancing. It was a real meat market. Guys kept brushing up against me. And despite what Rob says, I wasn't looking for any of that. Anyway, I just went outside to get away, to get some air. And as I was standing there, he walked past. Didn't even notice me. He went into a store and he came out a minute later and all he had was a piece of licorice. And I thought it was kind of cute, you know? A grown man going into a store to buy one piece of licorice. And he was going to walk past me again without noticing me. So I said, hey, where's my piece? I guess I was a little drunk. And without missing a beat, he turned around, went back to the store, and came back with a red piece and a black piece. And so I took the red piece and he started talking.
We'd love to meet him.
Oh, sure. But I haven't really explained things to him yet about Rob and the plan.
So you're sticking to the plan?
Oh, yeah. I made a promise, didn't I? Oh.
Hi, is that Terry? Hello, this is Rob from your analytic theory class. Rob, I sat behind you. Yeah, that's right, I'm that older guy. Yeah, well, I aced it, but... Oh, really? No, well, that's a highly respectable mark. Listen, what are you doing this Friday night? Well, it just so happens I have an extra ticket for the Bob Dylan concert. Yeah, he's still alive. Okay, no, I understand. It's important to just take it easy once in a while. Okay, thanks. Bye-bye. Oh, started already. they can sense the desperation. I no longer have that same cool air around me.
But Melanie's agreed to stick to the plan.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, we still have the plan. Hi, is Stacy there, please? Sure.
Single too long, you have that smell. It's the sad thing about love. People who need it the most are in the worst position for getting it. So, the lonely stay lonely.
Hi. Yeah, hi. Oh, she's gone to lunch. No, it's okay. No message. Thank you. Bye-bye.
Okay. Come on, I thought you'd be happy.
I'm happy, but I don't know. I haven't met him yet.
Oh, he's really sweet. I took him to see my paintings yesterday. Mm-hmm. God, you know how Rob is. He'd look at my stuff and be all analytical. Say stuff like, oh, you're really improving in this area. Or, you know, this is good, Mel, but perhaps a little derivative. Or, you haven't really committed to his style, blah, blah, blah. God, when I took Glenn, he was like floored. He was like, wow, Mel, I love this. I showed him that new piece I've been working on. He actually had tears in his eyes.
Really?
Yes, I know. It's great.
Still.
What?
Well, he is trying to get you in the sack.
Oh, God, you're so suspicious.
No, I'm not.
Can I make your pout face?
Anyway, I'm not suspicious. Realistic, maybe.
Oh, what does that make me, naive?
No, but he is a guy, and he probably just wants to fuck you.
Wow, you know who you're starting to sound like?
Who? No.
Mm-hmm.
Really?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, that's disturbing. Well, you want to know what's really scary?
What's that?
I actually think Rob might be right. I think you might be kind of rushing into this thing with Glenn.
I'm not rushing. Christ, 2 dates.
Well, how are you going to find the right person if you don't shop around a bit?
Well, how do you know they're not the right person if you don't get to know them? Oh, man.
What?
You were right. This was a bad idea.
Rob decided to include Steve in his search for a new girlfriend.
COVID, he has to selfie down with COVID.
Yeah, COVID. Like you could buy it before, I think the DVD was released, you could buy a VHS copy over the net. I think something like
that. We caught up with Melanie later that day.
No, you can't come with me.
Why not?
Glenn doesn't want to be in your movie.
He doesn't like Rob's idea?
No, he thinks Rob's idea is sort of intriguing. It's just that he's very suspicious of the media. He doesn't think our private lives should be turned into some mass consumer product or something like that. Sorry.
Would you be willing to wear a microphone?
Oh, I couldn't do that. Sorry. I want your film, your movie to be good, but I just couldn't do that. Not at the stage in the relationship. Sorry.
Town, keep going till she brings you together. I don't want to hear that joke again. What do you think? Okay, she's there. Okay, we gotta find some partner. Come on. Over there.
Can we do this?
Look, 2:00.
Oh, man.
Hey there.
What were you doing?
It appears I was spying on him, doesn't it?
Why were you spying on him?
Not for the reasons you're thinking.
You had different reasons.
Mm-hmm. Melanie's been hiding this guy for a week now. I don't think that's in the spirit of the agreement.
Spying on her in the spirit of the agreement?
How am I supposed to help her if I don't know what's going on?
What information have you gathered by spying on her?
A lot, actually. You notice how she never mentions his looks? She's always playing up how sweet and thoughtful he is. He's very good-looking, isn't he?
You think?
Don't let the goodwill grandpa pants and greasy hair fool you, my friend. Look closer. He's got that classic strong forehead, the jutting jaw, the big baby eyes. Face it, Melanie's heart is hot-wired to her clit. It's painfully Darwinian. It's embarrassing, really. She wants that phenylethylamine rush so bad, she let herself fall for the first guy made her feel a little moist.
You really think that can be controlled?
Well, she doesn't want to control it, which is why she's hiding him. She knows she's up to her usual shit, repeating her usual patterns, being impulsive instead of making real choices. You know, I thought this new method of loving might free her from some of that, but instead she's acting like a true neurotic.
What do you mean by that?
Well, she's avoiding situations where she might become aware of said behavior, have to deal with it.
Such as
introducing this guy, this Glenn, to me. Okay, well, we seem to be about on schedule. You may have jumped ahead a little bit, maybe, but that's okay. Should work out just fine. Right?
Yep.
Yeah, good. Thinking maybe we should have this Glenn over for dinner. How about that?
I think it's too soon.
Too soon. All right. Don't want to rush into anything. Why is that? Are you ashamed of him or something?
No, I just don't think it's a good time.
Is he employed? What kind of work does he do, this guy?
He's a musician.
Musician, so he's unemployed. Okay, why don't you let me do that?
No, it's all right.
You have to do up the buttons. Just give me... Thank you. Don't start that shit with me, okay?
What are you talking about?
Passive-aggressive shit.
What passive-aggressive shit?
Is something bothering you?
No.
That passive-aggressive shit, right?
Look, I said nothing's wrong.
Okay, I know, your mouth said fuck off. And so, you know, that's basically what I interpret. When your tone says fuck off, okay? Your mouth said nothing, but your tone said fuck off. I hate you. This is what I heard, tonally. It's called subtext.
Why can't you just talk like a normal person?
What is that?
Why don't you try saying what you feel? Try being intuitive.
Well, I'm intuitive, Melanie. I'm plenty intuitive. Just because I think before I speak doesn't mean I'm not intuitive. You want to know why you're so angry?
No.
Okay.
And I'm not angry.
Okay. I suppose this Glenn was more intuitive because he cried when he saw your paintings, right?
What? He didn't cry.
Why? Oh, really?
Who told you that?
I don't know. Why shouldn't I know that?
Because I don't want you analyzing me or him.
Okay, what am I going to say? That he's clearly manipulative, possibly psychotic?
Oh, psychotic.
Mm-hmm. Crying for no reason? Does he laugh at inappropriate moments, too?
Well, you think without your guidance I'm going to end up with an insane person? Give me some credit, would ya?
What about the guy who beat up your dad?
Oh, that was just...
What about the guy you caught jerking off into your shoe?
Okay, look, nobody got
hurt. What about
the
guy who jerked...
Fuck off, Rob! Jesus!
Okay, look. All I'm saying is I care about what happens to you. Now, one of the good things about this agreement is we can sort of protect one another from getting hurt. So don't shut me out. I just want to see you happy. Peace. That was fine.
No, it was just... Oh.
Well, technically, we're still together.
Okay, look, I can't be sleeping with both of you, all right? It's just too weird.
I'm sleeping with him.
Don't wait up for me.
Well, wait a minute. What about my question? You said I could ask a question.
Okay. Fine. What do you want to know so badly?
Is his cock bigger than mine?
Is that what you really want to know? It's really sad.
A lot of my focus, as of late, has been on Melanie. So I've neglected really examining what it is that I'm looking for. Who I'd like to spend the next 19 months with.
And what did you come up with?
Initially, I made up a list of all the women I currently know. And this is friends, friends of friends, classmates, women I've had a few dates with. Now, typically, these are the people we go out with. I accused Melanie of going after the first guy that came along, but at least she was able to get outside the obvious circle of people she knows. So, if not the obvious, then what? Well, I delved into my sexual history and my dating past. This is everything from long-term relationships to women I'd adored from a distance. Certain patterns began to emerge. Yeah. See, I realized that basically I've always chased after very attractive women. And when I've had them, I wished I was with an even more attractive woman. Now, that's not unusual, but what's the point in that? It's just skin. Seriously, I mean, you turn out the lights and sex feels virtually the same with anyone. So why am I wasting my time with these high-maintenance beauties? Why not go for a plain girl? My name is Rob. I live across the hall from you, and I'm in the process of breaking up with my girlfriend. I've seen you around a few times. I thought you might like to go out with me.
Some kind of joke?
No, this is no joke.
Just a second.
It's okay, this is good. I feel comfortable, like I can be myself.
Sorry, what did you want?
I'd like to take you out and get to know you. I've seen you around. I think you have a quality.
Quality?
Yeah. A spark. A spark. I feel there's something between us. Do you feel it?
I don't know.
What's your name?
Lisa.
Hi. Lisa, I'm Rob. Hi. So, well, what do you say, shall we? Don't worry about them. They're making a little documentary on the nature of love in the new millennium. It's very respectable.
This isn't some kind of joke.
No, this is no joke, I swear.
Well...
Lisa, I'm not gonna take no for an answer. I want you to go in there and put on something nice. Go get a coffee, all right?
All right.
Okay. I like this better already.
So, you strike me as someone who likes to read.
Yeah, I love reading.
Mm, yeah, I'm a big fan of all the women writers. Yeah, you're Atwood, Friedman, Murdoch, Winterson, of course Jane Austen.
Have you read any Lillian Jackson Braun?
No, I don't. Who's that?
She writes these books about these cats that help solve mysteries.
Like a house cat?
Yeah. Siamese. Yum Yum and Coco.
Doesn't seem plausible, but...
I really love cats.
You have a cat?
No. Oh. No, I'm allergic.
Good.
I wish. You're allergic too?
No. I mean, in a way. In a way. So, what do you do when you're not reading about this cat?
The usual stuff, you know, I go to work, I watch television. Sometimes I make my own clothes.
Oh. Oh, did you make that?
Mm.
Really?
Yeah.
Well, that's really something.
Thank you.
Yeah, that's kind of, that's kind of campy, right? Kind of, campy.
Campy.
If it's so bad, it's good, kind of.
Thing
going on there. Yeah. Melanie is an artist as well.
Who?
Melanie, the woman I'm breaking up with.
Oh. Why are you breaking up?
Just time, you know?
You don't get along.
Yeah, it's something like that. What about you? How come a girl like you doesn't have a boyfriend?
I don't know. I don't know. Oh.
Thank you, sir.
It's all foamy.
That's cappuccino. Lisa, I'm going to be completely honest with you. You're not what I'm looking for right now. Physically, you're fine, but I was hoping we'd have a lot more in common. I wouldn't be opposed to having sex with you, however. It would help me out a great deal, and I think it might be good for you, too. Lisa.
Earlier that day, Melanie and Glenn came to pick up her things.
What are you doing?
I'm moving in with Glenn. Well, for the meantime, anyway.
What about the agreement?
Well, you know, the more I thought about it, and the more I talked to Glenn about it, it just wasn't working for me.
Well, I would say you're just doing what you always do. Running from one relationship, obviously, into another.
Yeah, well, Rob would say that. I mean, as you've probably noticed, Rob says a lot of things.
Is he wrong?
I don't know. Nobody I find is going to stand up to his line of questioning. I mean, he'll just find fault, he'll run them down. I don't want him to spoil this for me.
Is this such a good thing if you're afraid of Rob's questions?
Look, if I'm wrong, I'd rather just find out for myself. You know? Anyway, I gotta go.
Note how far to the right everything is slanted.
What does that mean?
Oh, she's impulsive. Clearly hasn't thought this through.
See her indecisiveness whenever she writes I. I suspect she's been talked into this. The signature is practically illegible. She's hiding something. I think it's not so much from me, but from herself. T's aren't crossed. Tells you something. Not sure what. Lots of spelling mistakes.
What does that tell you?
It tells me she's a stupid bitch. Good riddance.
It's nice to just chill once in a while.
Hey, buddy.
Really underestimated single life. You got a great setup here, Steve. Yeah, I've had some time to do some soul searching, and being in a relationship really corrupts you.
Yeah?
Mm-hmm. You tend to cheat on yourself. You may find you've lost who you are, and you've become who the other person needs you to be. It's like I'm looking at the last 10 CDs I bought. It's not stuff that I love. It's stuff that I knew Melanie and I could listen to together. It's that femmy fucking massage music. Scary thing is, I'd actually convince myself I liked it. See, what's this? The Warriors. Never even heard of them.
No, it's a movie. That's a DVD.
You are the champ. Fucking Warriors on DVD he's got. This is what I'm talking about. So you can't be in a serious relationship and have the Warriors on DVD. You got your own stuff. You got your own place. You got your own mind. I just think if we stick to my plan of staying single and having casual sex with unattractive women, we'll have it made.
I don't know any unattractive women.
Mm. They're everywhere. Friend, there will be no more Yokos. Up this morning and found myself alone, and you know what? I couldn't have been happier. I've avoided the solitary life as if it were some sort of plague, and why, I really don't know. And if you think of all those great men working alone in their dark, dank rooms, your Kafkas, your Gogols, your Van Goghs, something like true inspiration doesn't visit the man who surrounds himself with distractions, with girlfriends, and televisions, music, video games, pornography. No. It tiptoes up on the man alone, the one riding on the edge of his sanity.
Rob didn't truly feel he was alone with the crew around all the time, so he asked us to leave for the weekend. We couldn't catch up with Melanie, so I was stuck with the crew to keep busy. Fortunately, we had the foresight to leave a wireless microphone hidden in Rob's apartment.
my door at around 3 a.m. It was Rob. I thought he was back for some more. And it was Saturday, so I didn't mind that it was so late. But he just curled up in my bed and kind of clung to me all night. I didn't mind. You know, it was nice to sleep with somebody again. The first night, anyway.
He called and said that he needed Melanie's number. He had some of her stuff, she had some of his, you know, the usual. So I called Melanie, and she said she didn't want me to give him the number, so I didn't. But then he kept calling, and at first it was kind of amusing, I have to admit. I even think he was crying at one point. Actually, he seemed really fucked up. I felt sorry for him for about 2 seconds, but then the calls kept coming and I started ignoring them, had to turn off my ringer, turned off the answering machine, and then he showed up at my door and I wouldn't let him in, but he wouldn't go away, so.
Then what happened?
Nothing happened.
You gave him the number?
Yeah, I gave it to him. Well, why should I be the one who has to change your number? I just think that it's time that Melanie dealt with her own mess.
Yeah, went a little crazy on the weekend. Good crazy, productive crazy. Realized some things.
What did you realize?
I think what Melanie's doing is wrong. I mean, letting her get away with it is wrong. You can't just shut someone out of your life the way she has. It's not fair. We had an agreement. I just let her walk away from it. What'd she learn from the whole experience, huh? Can't be looking very good in your little film here. I don't want this thing coming out. She looks like some total bitch.
Aren't you worried about how you're going to come out?
Me? Well, never even thought about that. How long is this thing going to be?
Around 90 minutes.
90 minutes, huh? You've got hours and hours of footage, right? Yeah, I've taken a few film courses. I'm aware if you were so inclined, you could cut this together in a most unflattering way. String together all the worst moments and make me seem obsessive or even jealous.
You don't feel you've been obsessive and jealous?
No, not if you look at the big picture.
What about the phone calls?
Yeah, I made a few phone calls, so what?
Hi, this is Glenn.
And Melanie.
Please leave a message.
Hi, Melanie. I bumped into Paige last night. She gave me a new number. So, hope you're doing all right. Listen, there's still a few things we need to deal with here, just bills and whatnot. So, give me a call. I'll be up late. Hey, it's Rob again. I guess you're still out. Listen, I think you may have picked up my Van Morrison CD, Astral Weeks. Yep, that's it. So, call me. You guys are quite the partiers, aren't you? It's 2:30. I'm still up, so give me a call. What's going on there? Is everything all right? It's after 3. I hope you're not just screening my calls. So I guess you're just being a cunt. I hope your fucking teeth fall out, you selfish little bitch. Seriously, though, give me a call. Hey, Glenn, you motherfucker. I'll chop your fucking hands off. I'll light your filthy fucking hemp jeans on fire, because I know what you look like, you pretty boy fucking slacker. Pick the fucking phone up, you cocksucking bitch. I want my CD back. I want my fucking 19 months back. Hey, Melanie, look, I said some stupid things last night. Sorry, but I think they needed to be said, so I'm ready for us to move on now and be friends and all like we promised we would. Call me.
Melanie. Oh my God! Wow, how you doing? Listen, we're gonna bump into each other sooner or later. Why don't we get a coffee? Why don't we get?
Fuck
why don't
off,
we get?
Rob.
Whoa. Listen, why don't we just have a nice talk? Why don't we just... It's okay. She's crazy. I don't know what she's so afraid of. If we could just sit down and talk about this like adults, you know?
What now?
I don't know. I don't know. What would you do?
Me?
Yeah, you must fancy yourself something of an expert by now. What would you do?
Rob turned out to have one more trick up his sleeve.
What now?
Glenn thinks I should call the police.
What do you think?
I don't want to have to do that again. I just want my paintings back. Do you have any idea what he's done with them?
I couldn't tell you.
Why do they always go crazy? I mean, is it me?
You think he's gone crazy?
Let's talk.
You know what I want. I want for us to talk. Well, I want to know what happened. Because I want to know what you think you're doing. Okay, then I want to know more about this claim. No. Not now. It's too easy for you to... You could say anything. I want to see your face. Because you could just... Well, maybe I do just want to see it. What's wrong with that? Well, I saw you every day for 18 months. Now I don't even know where you live. That's not fair, is it? What? A cracker. Okay, great, fine. Okay, wait. One more thing. I would like to get that CD back. Yeah, well, I know I gave it to you, but I don't like the idea of you and Glenn listening to it together. Okay. Yeah, I know you could just go out and buy another one, but I don't... Okay, fine. If you want your paintings back... Oh. I didn't tell her where or when. Yeah, hi.
Rob and Melanie arranged to meet the next afternoon.
I brought you a painting.
Oh, Christ, Rob, I don't want to drag all over the city.
Okay, I thought you'd want to see one.
What I want is to see them all back in my studio.
Okay, your paintings.
I want this damage. This is one of my favorites.
I know, I like that one too.
Really?
Yep. It's good, no?
Thank you.
Is that the one that made Glenn cry, or?
Oh, don't start.
So how are things?
Fine.
Fine?
Things are fine.
Just fine?
Fine, good, whatever. So, what does you want to know so badly?
Everything.
What do you mean, everything?
Everything. I used to know everything. Now I know nothing. I got this hole inside.
Don't.
No. Okay.
It was a little crazy.
Well, that's what happens when we break up.
You said you weren't going to do that.
Yeah.
You said you weren't going to do that. You said we people we talked about that, how cool that was and how so stupid that is.
It sounded good at the time.
Then why did you agree to it if you're going to just ignore it the second it gets
to you? Look, I didn't ignore it, okay?
Fine,
I tried.
Nice talking to you.
Okay, well, what about the promises you've broken?
What? Like what?
Like not getting jealous.
I'm not jealous.
What?
I'm not. Not in the way you
think.
No, not in the way you think. No.
You've been acting crazy.
Like how? Stealing your papers?
Yeah, for one.
Okay, but how else was I supposed to see it?
Rob and Melanie spent the next hour talking and appeared to come to some kind of mutual understanding.
Wanted to meet him.
What did she say?
She told me to fuck myself. Apparently he's afraid to meet me. Thinks I'm fucking crazy. Wants to buy a gun.
So, no meeting?
If she wants her paintings back, there will be.
Hello? Hi, Dad.
Rob locked himself back in his apartment without explanation. We didn't hear a peep for 3 days. We grew concerned about Rob and tried to contact him.
Rob? Rob, we had an agreement. Rob?
He locked himself in his room, right? Rob's been doing that since he was 6 years old. Rob is fine. Don't worry about Rob.
What happened?
I told him that he should get a job. I told him that I'm not going to pay for any more of his bachelor degrees. And naturally, he had several reasons why he wanted to stay in school. So I don't think that there's much point in trying to discuss this any further with you guys. I mean, he talks to me about wanting to write a book one of these days that's going to cover every imaginable discipline. He talks about, talking about this book that's going to change the way we think about living and loving. I'm supposed to pay for that?
So you showed him some tough love?
I showed him. Love is tough. Love is tough. Excuse me, please.
Despite his father's lack of concern, we really felt we needed to check on Rob.
Up there.
What do you see?
that day, we got a call from Melanie. Rob asked Steve to return the paintings.
I'm glad he got his mind back. Being crazy like that didn't suit him. I mean, I'd always encourage him to be more intuitive, but I guess that was a bad idea.
You think you can still be friends?
Oh, I hope so. I've invited him to the show. And you were right, it seemed wrong not to. I mean, all of this work here represents our time together. I mean, it's not necessarily about Rob, but it wouldn't be the same if he weren't in my life. You know, when you're that close with someone, they influence you. They influence everything. Do you know what I mean?
It can be a good thing or a bad thing, I would imagine.
Yeah, sometimes. You just need to get away from it. At least for a while.
How are things with Glenn?
Oh, you know.
Shouldn't you tell him?
I'll have to know.
So what happened with Mr. Perfect?
Oh, it wasn't that he wasn't perfect. I mean, he wasn't, but I don't know, I don't think that was the problem. I think it was more just that his flaws weren't compatible with mine.
How do you mean?
Well, when we weren't fucking, I think we just kind of felt annoyed with one another. No?
Yeah. But this is the man who cried at your painting.
Yeah, but he also cried at the end of Sandler film.
Oh.
He's not exactly a frequent bather, either.
What?
I mean, say what you will about
Ew.
Rob. I know, but at least he kept himself clean.
Oh, I can't believe you didn't tell me that.
Why would I tell you that?
So gross.
But, oh, and remember how cute I thought it was when I first met him and he had that one piece of licorice? He's just cheap.
Cheap.
Yeah, it's very frugal anyway.
Too bad.
Yeah.
Spent 3 days trying to come to some sort of conclusion and trying to come up with some kind of answer, but became confused. I couldn't even remember what the question was. At some point, I'm not sure why, but at some point, I just started throwing these cards at his hat. Sometimes they went in, and mostly they missed, and mostly they missed by a bit. Sometimes they missed by a lot. And I could swear to you, I threw the ones that went in and the ones that missed exactly the same. See? See, there's fussy little laws in nature so that the slightest imperfection in your throw can cause you to miss your intended target. Even if you had a perfect understanding of those laws, you'd still miss the target some of the time, because it's not that the laws are imperfect. That the human throwing the cards always will be. You know what I'm saying? I mean, take jealousy. I had no intention of being jealous. I made every attempt not to be, but you could argue that I exhibited some of the classic behavior. You know, I read about the study they did where they took a bunch of 19-month-old babies and sat them down with their mothers. Then they had the moms go off and pay attention to some other kid while the babies just went nuts. They just started bawling. So I guess you could say it's innate. It's in our DNA, so to speak. The really sad part is even knowing about it doesn't save you from doing it anyway.
What now? caught up with Rob and Melanie 3 months later.
So you're back together?
Yeah. Well, I guess you could say that.
What about the 19 months?
Oh, we're not doing that anymore. Stupid.
Oh, it's not stupid. The idea itself is pretty sound. It just didn't work.
Why didn't it work?
Well, certain things weren't taken into account. Certain tendencies.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, let's look at the big picture. Why do so many relationships fail these days? In the past, people got married and found a place, maybe had some babies.
Oh, yeah.
And then, after a while, the man and the wife, they begin to have affairs. What with a secretary, a stewardess, a business friend. And maybe the woman, too, with a tennis instructor or the local poet. But they stuck together. Wasn't perfect, but no one gave them the crazy idea of what
they... Oh, they knew they had each other. Mm-hmm. At the end of the day, you know, they knew that that person would be there.
Mm-hmm. I think we underrate that now. Everything has to be so sexy all the time. Everyone panics when the lust dies.
Has the lust died for you, too?
Why?
Oh, well, we had some great makeup sex when we first got
back
together.
Oh, yeah. It's kind of calmed down now. But it's nice.
Mm-hmm.
So what now?
Well, I think we're committed to going through this life together and not letting the usual obstacles bring us down.
Technically, we can see other people.
Mm-hmm. Technically.
Rob and Melanie toughed it out for another year, but have since gone their separate ways. Melanie says she's dating again, but isn't looking for anything serious right now. She wants to focus more attention on her work and is hoping to spend some time in Paris or Prague. Rob, meanwhile, finds himself alone as well. He's written 17 pages of his book, but is only happy with the first 7. Rob is working full-time as he earns his 1-year Business Information Systems diploma at DeVry. He's become increasingly interested in Eastern philosophy and has been successfully celibate now for 9 weeks.
How far we can go. Remember those loving fools, Romeo and Juliet? They thought they had a thing going, but they just didn't know. They couldn't visualize. They had no idea how it could really be, but we know.
Me and you.
Wasting our time fussing and fighting like other people. We're gonna be too busy being in love. Because this is the real thing. We found the groove. We move each other. We turn each other on. And this could last forever. All we need to do is give some kind of sign. Yes, love. From then on, baby, it's easy. Let's talk about me and you.
Worth it.
What happened with Rob?
He wasn't.